So I think that that all just naturally took place on its own. It was, you know, it happened on a gradient. It wasn't like overnight. You saw the sort of, you know, the evolution of this character over 5 years. So it's really one day at a time, one scene at a time. And I really have the writers to credit because I had no idea that Regina was going to become this hero. I thought she was going to be the evil queen forever. And then we saw the shift in the second season. It's funny because I went back. I'm kind of a nerd when it comes to Once Upon a Time. I know, and that's why I'm here. But I like going back and watching the shows, the episodes, and seeing the evolution. And sometimes I have to because of work. We'll look on the timeline and I'll call the producers and go, okay, wait, when was this before or after Hansel and Gretel? Okay, but now is this right before she became evil? Or is it like right as like she on her way? So I have to kind of do a lot of research. And that helps quite a bit. But I think as far as the emotions go, I mean, it was a natural evolution. You know, I'm constantly trying to show different colors in this character. I think that's what keeps me interested, and I think that's what keeps you all interested, is that, you know, not one human being is two-toned. We are complex. And sometimes it's really hard for us to show all those complexities, but through these characters and for my love of acting, I'm able to do so. So it was just a natural progression.
Thank you so much, Lana.
You're welcome.